Friday practice, we're just waiting to get out, waiting for that green light to come on. Absolutely itching. Turned around a little bit early on after that. I think it's just the newness.
Yeah, but it felt different to the 180.
Oh, this is the 180 now.
Yeah, so it's more fun.
It's better.
Yeah,
better,
yeah.
The other one, when you're right over, it always felt like it was just about to start moving. But this just feels solid.
Yeah, good. Suspension's about there.
There's always a few little tweaks you want to get done just to make the bike perfect. Practice day done, bike's good, off to scrutineering, ready for tomorrow. Day and we're just waiting for our time slot for time practice. I'd come in quite early, but I'd put in some good time, so I was on lap record pace. No need to stress the motor or the bike.
The right hand footrest, the edge of it has got like a really smooth bit, and then for scrutineering they put a blob of silicone in at the end because the ends have to be blank, and the silicone had partly fallen out, and I'm looking down at it, my foot was sliding off, and I was convinced I had oil on my foot peg, so I couldn't get really commit to the bike at all. Race one soon came around, I was on pole position and feeling good. However, the weather was starting to close in and it was starting to get a little bit cool.
from the start, the bike didn't feel right. Running into the old hairpin and into McLean's, the front of the bike would tremor and patter slightly through the front suspension, causing the bike to run wide at the exit. Again on the exit of the old hairpin, it ran wide onto the curb. By this point I'd had enough and decided to slow down and let Dean pass. Laps though, I realised I was quite a bit faster into and through the chicane and round Redgate, so I decided to get back in front of him and use the rest of the race as a bit of a coaching session.
Thank you.
Yeah, made a mess, a right mess at the start. And then Mark Cronshaw kind of got under my feet a bit going down the hill. And then Ant and Woodward got away a little bit, so I thought I'll try and close them down. But going into the old Irpin particularly, it was just juddering and juddering the front end. And then going into the McLean's again, it just juddered. And it had no confidence in turning in. So, I mean, I think we'll try a new front tyre, but there's something very unhappy about it.
Time for race two. There'd been a heavy shower the race before us, so everyone was a bit apprehensive what the grip was going to be like. First bit was going down Crane up to the old hairpin. Everyone was tiptoeing down the hill, me included.
Couple of laps.
It's just, I mean, through the start finish chicane down to turn one is all right, but as you're dropping down Hollywell into Craner curves, it just gets wetter and wetter and wetter. And on the second warm up lap, then when I went through the left, going really steady, both wheels are just kind of moving about and sliding. It's just awful.
And this is supposed to be for fun.
Yeah, and it ain't fun for me.
Give him his birthday kiss.
No one had told us it was Dean's 18th birthday today. Couldn't help but give the young'un a squeeze.
have you been doing?
We've just shortened the shock length and we're just altering the front rebound and compression a little bit. We're just trying to stop this chatter.
Ali Grant from Kramer was here, so he was on hand to do some fine tuning to get the suspension working. We just had to sort this patter out. Then it was time to get the garage all cleared out, ready for the Supermono GB social evening. And tonight was going to be a big barbecue. Later on in the evening, the Widdowson family put on a really good party for Dean. Sunday, the sun had put its hat on and it was gorgeous. Nice and warm, everyone was buzzing, including me. We think we'd sorted the handling problem. However, I was in for a bit of a shock when I got up to the holding area to give us place 34, which is effectively the back row, because I hadn't finished in the last race. Mind out, people, bloke in a hurry here.
And you, thank you, mate. Have a good safe ride.
All right.
Oh, nice paintwork, mate.
Hold on a minute.
Mark Cronshaw lost his garage again.
I sort of set off and stopped to set off and look, what's fucking happening?
Yeah. So the deal is that everybody got off the line, everybody got sick, and then we got down to the old hairpin and then red lights.
Yeah,
no, I thought it would be a big
crash, isn't it?
Oh no, redoing the scar. Yeah. So it's another fucking lap.
Yeah. And the sighting lap. You didn't need a sighting lap, you can go again.
Never mind.
It's better, but it still wants to start to chatter. What I started doing, was just hold a tiny straight like that, and it wants to start. Whether that's the angle of lean that you're at, but it's just as you're dropping into the apex. So what I was doing is just hanging onto the brake a little bit, and then as soon as I let the brake off, go off the throttle, so there was no downtime. But because I was doing that, I was slowing down too much. So then I had to adjust how fast I was going into the corner. So, well, I'm dodging back now.
Third place, Dennis Mack.
Then it was time for the last race of the weekend. The weather was still good and I was really up for it, starting from pole position this time.
believe it though, after the warm-up lap, as I'm rolling up towards the line, the motor cut out and I only just managed to get it started again.
Dean's bike had broken down, so it was a DNF, I'm afraid, for Dean. Dean's bike didn't sound good at all. There wasn't enough time for a motor change, so there was no option really other than to console him and get him out on my bike. He'd still got one race to do, the national supermono race.
When you were behind me?
I'd had a belting race with young Joe, a really up and coming talent, and he'd come along for a race debrief.
If you go in early, you go in tight, you're going to run out wide. The best is you're going to run out wide.
It was well worth him getting out on my bike with a rostrum placing. Kelsey had a cracking race too, winning her class.
Marquez does. What does Marquez do?
I have no idea.